Do you know what the word nuts stands for?
No.
N-U-T-S stands for Never Underestimate the Spirit.
I love it.
I feel the honor that I'm getting from the state of Oklahoma. A miracle and a blessing. And it can't be left alone because I have a stamp in my heart from my angels and spiritual guides to let me know that it's okay, Gary, you're here now. It's just as simple as that. It's okay, you're here now.
That's great.
And be sure and look out of your eyes with love to everyone. And have that love in your heart you give to everyone. It's great. I went down on a motorcycle December 4th, 1988, and split my skull wide open, knocked a hole in it, and died after brain surgery and went to the spiritual realm and got information you can't get here and realized how important and beautiful life is. And the word life, L-I-F-E, that stands for living in forever eternity. Death, D-E-A-T-H, stands for don't expect a tragedy here, because death and dying are earth words. But when you go, a guide takes you there, and it's the most beautiful feeling of freedom and trust and love you ever have, I've ever had. You don't have that kind of feeling here on earth because our spirits are trapped in the dense body we live in. But that's okay too, because look at all the bodies here. They're absolutely fabulous. Don't judge, don't criticize, and don't argue, because all of those things are destructive ways to your personality, your health, and your mental fabric.
There's a lot of fear on earth, it feels like.
Fear. I'm going to take the letters that spell fear and give you a definition of fear. F-E-A-R stands for false evidence appearing real. So the persons who are in fear, they create it themselves without knowing it consciously. And the word doubt, D-O-U-B-T, that stands for debating on understanding bewildering thoughts. And when you debate with yourself, there are no winners. You can't win debating yourself, buddy.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's fun to do, but...
And you're not going to get anywhere, that's for sure.
Well, you get somewhere. You're like Samba, that kid, that little Indian kid, you know, East Indian that ran around the tree and created butter from his feet on the ground. You want to make butter? Run around a tree.
Advice for young actors who want to become a success?
Well, my advice for young actors, first of all, you must know that everyone has the ability to perform, whether it's sculpting, painting, acting, singing, music. It's just a beautiful way of expressing your truth. And the way to do it is get an education. You must get the education. You must study theatrical art. Theatrical art is the fulcrum of the teeter-totter of drama and comedy. They both go together and they're both the same. If you'll notice that when you're laughing, you can go right into crying. The only thing difference is your eyes go like that instead of like that. It's all in your face, it's all in your heart. And remember this, that acting is the absence of acting. It's believing in the truth of the moment you're creating in your heart at that time. And I build backstories for the characters I played. For instance, Mr. Joshua in Lethal Weapon, his backstory was he would walk through his grandmother's blood to get a postage stamp and never look at her. He was cold. I think I spent the whole movie like, yeah, what do you want now? If you tell me where the shipment is coming in, I promise I'll kill you quick. No emotions, but everything inside is raving anger and mercenary, a killer of men without effort. There's another one gone. That's good for the earth. Less population makes happier people, you know. I created the philosophy of Mr. Joshua, as I do with everybody, but the one that came so automatically and free, okay, the part I played was given to play. It came so automatically and free, and that was playing Buddy Holly in the Buddy Holly story. And I realized a few months after the movie, my posture was different. I felt smaller. And I realized that Buddy Holly's spirit was singing through me. That is not acting. That is giving. So the young actors, the kids who want to be actors, don't get in your own way. Don't be in judgment of others. Don't criticize. Don't feel bad because this guy got a part or this girl got a part that you didn't get. It's just the stair steps to the success level of standing in the light. You stand in the light when you accept yourself for everything you are, everything you've done, and you know automatically what's coming is better than the last. That's for the young actors and the old actors and everybody. It just goes together with the stew of life. Life is a stew. Whoever made it, they did a good job. Just be sure not to eat the gristle. You got to remove the gristle from the bowl and say, okay, give that to the... Don't give it to anybody. Just put it out there.